sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day.
When he started the Sankirtan movement in Navadvipa, he was chanting in Kirtan. Here they went to the Chan Kazi's house in Kirtan. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took sannyas and he went to Puri. And when he was in Puri, again he was doing Sankirtan, chanting. He didn't establish any temples, actually. Although he would go every day to the Jagannath temple and have darshan of Lord Jagannath. So one might say, well, why are we, you know, interested in deity worship, and why do we have temples where we have installed deities? Of course, if you look at the six Goswamis in Vrindavan, you see that they did establish temples. So, how is that? What's the relationship between the Sankirtan movement, the Yuga Dharma, and the process of Archana, deity worship? So, Srila Prabhupada explains that although the Yuga Dharma is the chanting of the holy name of the Lord, the age of Kali is so contaminated that Archana is very important for the Bhakta, Sadhana Bhakta, to perform in order to maintain the purity, right? To maintain a pure consciousness. One needs to perform Archana, a worship of the Lord. And therefore, we see that Srila Prabhupada, fairly early in the movement, within a year or so, established the worship of Lord Jagannath in San Francisco. So, this deity worship process, it has to be performed in a certain way. Now, Srila Prabhupada once wrote a letter that I thought was very, very strong. When I first became a new devotee, it was in St. Louis in 1973. And our GBC was Jagdish Prabhu, and he used to come to the St. Louis temple with his wife, Lakshmi Mohan. And she had received a letter from Srila Prabhupada that she brought to the temple and read to us all. We didn't really have deities at that time. We just had a picture of the Panchatattva. But that year, in 74, the summer of 1974, we installed Gornitai deities that we brought from here in Mayapur after we went to the Gorpurnima festival in 74. And that letter said that, you know, in the deity worship, you have to be very careful to do things in the right way. And if there's speculation, if you do speculation in the worship of the deities, it will ruin our whole movement. I thought that's a pretty strong statement. And therefore, we can understand how important it is to have a training program so that the worship of deities is very much standardized, and devotees are aware of what and how to worship the deity properly without any mental speculation, right? And so, therefore, this training program that has been established here in the Mayapur Academy is very, very, very important. And the more devotees that, and I saw personally, devotees that came here and went through the course, they have a feeling for worshiping the deity. They may be doing other services. Like in Juhu, we have devotees that, you know, work book tables or do other services, but they had been to the academy and gone through this program, and they really come forward to engage also in the archana process of worshiping the deities. So there's no doubt it that the two processes, the Bhagavad Vidhi, which is the chanting, and the archana, pancharatna vidhi, the two paths, two parallel paths. Prabhupada describes them like the two, like the rails of the train. They have to go together. They do go together. Similarly, you can't do deity worship without performing the chanting the holy name. And chanting the holy name is complemented and assisted by the process of worshiping the deities. So both things go together, and it's maintains the purity of our movement by having temples where the deity worship is properly performed. If you go to other temples, you call them Hindu temples or whatever, you won't find the same kind of attention that is there that Srila Prabhupada instilled in his followers in worshiping the deity. One time Srila Prabhupada, he saw that they had offered to him some dried flowers, not fresh, dried up flowers. So he became very concerned that they may be also offering these same kind of flowers to the deities, right? He said that you're worshiping Krishna and you have to be very careful. This is vigraha, vigraha, vigraha. And if you don't have that understanding that this is vigraha, means it's the form of Krishna and not different from Krishna, then you will, it'll become, instead of vigraha, it'll become Galagraha. You heard the same class, I guess. Become Galagraha, become a burden, right? So instead of an enlivening experience, it becomes like a routine and becomes something that's hackneyed and not so pleasant. So proper understanding is very important in rendering service to the deities. And such a wonderful way to interact with the Lord. The Lord comes in a form whereby which we can easily serve him, right? We can dress him, we can cook for him, we can make garlands for him, we can try to please him in various ways. So there becomes a relationship with Krishna. You do something for someone. The devotee that goes out and buys cloth for the deities, right? It's a very personal thing, right? So the devotees easily make nice advancement by worshiping the deity along with their sadhana bhakti of chanting. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Now, one time Srila Prabhupada was in Detroit and they were asking Srila Prabhupada questions, but before I get to the questions part, he was sitting in a garden. Srila Prabhupada was very relaxed. It was the Fisher Mansion. And I remember when Srila Prabhupada was walking through the Fisher Mansion, he was seeing all the gold embossing and the beautiful mosaics. And he turned around to his servant and he said, "This is our most beautiful temple." And then he added, "Except for Vrindavan." So while he was there in Vrindavan, he was sitting there and
He said, this is a nice place, but why are there no flowers? And one devotee replied, well, Srila Prabhupada, they had a peacock in the property in the Fisher Mansion. So the peacock ate all the flowers, Srila Prabhupada. And Prabhupada said, why don't you feed him? And the devotee said, well, Srila Prabhupada, what do peacocks eat? And Srila Prabhupada replied, peacock food. All the devotees laughed. But other devotees were asking Srila Prabhupada, the Radha Damodar traveling Sankirtan party was there. And I don't know, was anybody in Pancharatna Prabhu's class this morning? He talked about a little bit about the history of the Shishi Radha Damodar traveling Sankirtan. Very fired up devotees for book distribution. I remember one time, we used to love to have the Radha Damodar traveling Sankirtan party come to our St. Louis temple. Because their kirtans and their dancing was so ecstatic, so ecstatic. So they had come to visit the temple in the month of, in the fall, maybe early October, something like that. And they stayed for a few days, and it was really nice having them, and then they all left. A couple of weeks later, it got cold. At the end of October, it starts getting cold in St. Louis. So you need your little heavier jacket. So we went to get our jackets, and they were all gone. So maybe that was one of the reasons why some of the temple presidents would complain about them coming to the temple. But anyway, the process of deity worship is so important for our devotees' development. Everyone should learn the process, just like learning book distribution. It's also important for a devotee's development. And again, in Detroit, when Srila Prabhupada was there, the devotees from Radha Damodar were asking Srila Prabhupada questions about how to maintain their enthusiasm for book distribution. They were number one, so they were concerned how they would continue in that way. And they were kind of expecting a reply like, you should read the books or. But his answer was that you should worship the deities. That will maintain your enthusiasm.
Do you like our ad-free videos? Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.